When you use an ORM framework with Delphi, do you lose the RAD aspect of Delphi, rapid application development? At least with Aurelius, the answer is no. When you use, because of the T Aurelius dataset component. Here is a minimal Aurelius application that I will start with to show you how it works. We have this stick customer class with three properties, ID, name, and birthday. And here is the application, which is the kind of application people think of when we say ORM framework. It's a very handy-made application. We have here a button to create a customer, which creates an instance of the customer, set the property name based on the content of the editor, and save the customer. If you had more editors and properties here, we have to set manually to save a new customer. And we have a button list customers, which show a list of customers in the list box. This code here retrieves a list of T customer objects using the criteria API ordered by name, and we iterate through the list to add a new item in the list box for each customer we have. If you run the application here, I have pre-inserted some data in it. We see it in action. We list customers here. We see that it performed a select statement, and we see the list of existing customers. And if we want to create a new one, like Johnny, create customer, the insert into customer is performed, and the new customer inserted in the database. If we see the application this way, we indeed think, oh, this is going to be a lot of work to create editor forms, to create, to edit a new customer, to edit an existing customer, to add controls to the form and do all the linking and binding between the controls and the object. But that's where the Aurelius dataset comes in to help you out quickly with the binding between the form and the objects. I'm going to delete all those controls in this form here and add a DB grid as we are used to, T data source, and T Aurelius dataset. Let's bind then, link then, the grid to the data source to the data set, and let's add a button here to perform the operation. Let's delete the old code. We'll just keep the code that retrieves the list. Then here we have bring me a new list of customers and do this, close the data set, bring the list, set the list as a source of data for the data set, and open the data set. We also need to set the manager of the dataset to the manager we have. If you run, the application, we see now that our objects are being displayed here in the grid, the binding automatic. We see that the SQL statement is the same, select from customer. But if we come here and try to edit a record in the dataset, it will update the database accordingly. Note that the code behind the dataset didn't change, so I'm not actually using the dataset in the traditional way. I'm still retrieving the objects in the same way the objects are in memory. The only thing that the dataset helps, if only is a good word, is to bind the objects to the DBAware control. So it's binding the objects to the grid in this case. And when I do a post in the dataset, like here, when I change it to Andrea Smith, it updated the underlying object. And then the manager did the job of running the SQL statement for updating the name. I can also use set the birthday here. We can see that the birthday is updated. And we can even create a new name here, Mike. And we see that an insert statement was executed. That's how the dataset helps you to have an ORM application based using object-oriented approach, but still using the RED and design time and DB linking, DBAware linking that Delphi offers to us. There is more about the dataset. I'm going to open a new application here to show you some details. Here is another example. If you see this application in action, it's retrieving data from an existing database. It's a list of orders with the order details. So here is it shows how to use the dataset for master detail. As with any dataset in Delphi, you can define the fields. And you can use the same features of display name, title, display width, and default expression, calculate fields, and a lot of features that are already built in the dataset. It works with Aurelius dataset. Still remembering that it's all about dealing with objects in memory. Aurelius dataset also allows you to use properties of associations. This is an example. This field will show the property, the value of company name property of the customer object associated with the order. Then it's very easy to add fields of joined, if you want to use that word, of associated objects. And we have also the DDataset field here that we use to link the detail dataset for the order details. That's why I wanted to show you the Aurelius dataset is a very powerful tool for bringing your forms and not only forms, but whatever you want to use using the dataset. It's a bridge between the objects and the dataset. You can use it, for example, to leverage data Aurelius data in a dataset format for other third-party tool frameworks, for example, reporting tools. And the dataset is very powerful. That is, it deserves its own video series, blog series about it with a lot of features. But I wanted to show you the concept, and I hope I have been successful and show you how the dataset is in my top 10 Aurelius features. Thank you. Please subscribe to our channel to receive updates, notifications about updates and new videos from TMS Software TV.